are significant figures. The accuracy of every measurement has certain limitation and depends on the least count of the instrument which we have used. For instance, the time measured with the help of watch, which is having a second hand, can measure the time up to accuracy of 1 second. Just assume that you are measuring the length of a pencil. This is a pencil, right? Now keep one end of the pencil on the zero scale of the meter, and suppose its other end lie between say 12.3 and 12.4. So the least count of a meter scale is what? You have been using meter scale. This is 0.1 centimeter. So it does not have any marking between 12.3 and 12.4. So what to do? We can estimate, say, it to be 12.38. So we have certain these digits, that is 1, 2, 3 and 8. And in this 1, 2, 3 is precise. 1, 2, 3 is precise, right? But we are not sure about 8. We are not sure about 8. So the number of digits in a measurement about which we are certain, this is 1, 2, 3, plus one additional digit which is uncertain, as I just gave you example. So these 1, 2, 0.38, in this case 1, 2, 3 are precise, 8 is uncertain. Combine them, there are 4 in all, 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 4 significant figures. So in this example we have 4 significant figure, 1, 2, 3, 8. The larger number of significant figures we obtain in a measurement, the greater is the accuracy. And the number of significant digit, it depends on the least count also of the instrument which we have used for measurement. For instance, the radius of a rod which is measured with vernier caliper, say R equal to 0.25. For the same rod, if we measure it using the screw gauge, it can go up to 0.254. So in the first case, we have 2 significant digit, 1 or 2. And in the second one, we have 254. So we are having 3 significant digits. And this shows that this is more precise. So in mathematics, all the numbers are definite figures. So the question of significance will arise only when the number represents the measured value of the physical quantity. There are certain rules for determining the number of significant figure. First of all, we'll take this example. All the non-zero digits are significant. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 5, 6, 3. They are all non-zero, so all we will take. So 1, 2, 5, 6, 3, there are 5 significant figure here. In the second case, which the rule says, all the zeros between 2 non-zero digits are significant. So in this case, we have 2 zeros between 2 non-zero values. There is no matter where the decimal point is, if at all. So we, in this case, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, 6 significant figure. Because the zeros are between 2 non-zero digits. Now this is very important. This one will come in questions also. If the number is less than 1, so the number has to be less than 1. This number is 0.001507, so it is less than 1. So the zeros on the right of the decimal point, but to the left of the first non-zero digit, these are non-significant. So what it says is, in decimal point, this zero is insignificant. And these zeros are insignificant. The underlying zero here, these are not significant. So there are 1507, that is, there are 4 significant figures in this number. In a number without decimal point, if you have a number without decimal point, the zeros on the right side of the last non-zero digits are not significant. Very important. 132, 13200, 132000. 132 meter can be written as 13200 centimeter. It can be written as 132000 millimeter. This has only 3 significant digit, 1, 3 and 2. Because there is no change in the number of significant digit, because the 0 after decimal, right, 13200.0, 13200.0 after decimal point indicate the position value only. So by changing the units, even if the number of zeros increases, but the number of significant digit, they are not changing. They are always 1, 3, 2. Then the trailing zeros, these trailing zeros in a number with a decimal point, they are significant. So if here they were insignificant, but in this case, if we have a decimal, then the trailing zeros, they are significant. In this case, we ignore this. But 7900, so 00 has to be taken. They have these, this will have four significant figures. Now let us take an example. Write down the number of significant figure in the following. So 0.003 by rule 1, or say rule 3, sorry. 0, because it, this is a number less than 1, and this 0 has to be ignored, this has to be ignored, this has to be ignored. So there are only one significant figure. In this case, we have 0.1570. So because 0 is on the left side, we don't take it, it is less than 1, this is less than 1. But 157 and 0 is coming after decimal. So all these four are the significant digits. In 2.64 into 10 to the power 24, 10 to the power 24, we don't take this. Only 264, so there are three significant digits. In 7.590, 7 also, 5 also, 9 also, 0 also, because 0 is coming after the decimal. So we'll take all these four. In 6.032 also, 0 has to be taken because it is between two non-zero digits. So 6032, they are all four significant figures. In 3.012 into 10 to the power minus 4, we ignore this. 0 is between 3 and 1, so it means 3012, four significant figures. When we are adding, subtracting, multiplying and dividing, so what are the significant figures in this? Any physics experiment will involve a series of measurements, and each of these measurements, these are made up to a certain degree of accuracy, we know that. So the number of the significant figures depend on the least count of the measuring instrument, as we have seen about the vernier caliper and screw gauge. We will take an example. Suppose the resistance of two resistors, these are measured using meter, that is ohmmeter of different least count. And this is R1, 5.67, 12.345 and 0.7. How to add them? It's quite easy, 5.67. We'll take the decimal of the next one. So 12.345 and again 0.7. So we have to take the decimal and put values here and just add them. You will get 18.715. Now the question arises is, the significant figure here in this case and this case are different. Which to take? So when we add them, we get this. So the question is, are we justified in carrying out the sum like this? We have R1 as 5.67. So we don't have the information about the third digit after the decimal point. In the measurement of R3 here, this one, we don't have information about second and third. We don't have second and third also. We just place 0 and we added them to form 18.715. So it has only, this R3 has only one digit. So this shows that the precision in the measurement of R3 is less than other two resistors. Therefore, in the sum, the second and third digit becomes insignificant, right? This and this become insignificant. Only the least one will be taken. So we have to convert 18.715 in terms of the least one. This have 1, 2, 3 significant digits. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but this only has 1. Means we have to take the decimal after point, decimal only up to one value. So we can express it only as one decimal value. This will be, we have to convert or ignore 15 and write 18.71. So any result with more than one significant, they are, or uncertain digit, needs to be rounded off to the correct number of significant digit. And for that, we have certain rule. First of all, if we take 10.743. Now, if the insignificant digit to be dropped is, say, less than 5, then the preceding digit is left unchanged. For example, in this has to be rounded off, say, up till 7. So, after 7, what is there? This is 4, which is less than 5. So, we just ignore, we don't change here. This will remain as 10.7. But if the digit is to be dropped is more than 5, then the preceding digit is increased by 1. In case of 10.68, we have to take only 3 significant digits, so we have to change this, but this change will be dependent on this 8. 8 is greater than 5, so this 6 has to be made 7, that is, it will be 10.7. But what happens if the number is 7? Number is 5, because we said less than 5, let it be like this, greater than 5, increase it by 1. But if it is 5, then the preceding digit is increased by 1 if it is odd number, and if it is even, we leave it unchanged. In case of 10.45, because we have to change this, but this is 5, so we will not, this is odd, so we'll just keep it like 10.5. But in this case, 10.55. So this will be, because this is odd, this number is odd, and this is even, so we just left this, but this is odd, so we have to change it as 10.6. Addition subtraction. We need to understand certain point while carrying out addition and subtraction of two significant digits. If all the numbers are integers, the summation and subtraction will be carried out in normal way. There will be no issues. But if addition and subtraction, the final result should always or retain as many decimal places as there in number with the least decimal places. Please understand this. In addition and subtraction, the final result should retain as many decimal places as there in number with the least decimal places. I'll give an example. If we have resistance R3, 0.7, it has only one significant digit after the decimal place. So what we did, 18.715, we have to take only one significant digit after decimal. So 15 we ignore. It has to be rounded off. When we come to multiplication and division, in any measurement, the last digit is uncertain. We know that. So multiplication of any number with the least significant digit will also be insignificant. But the final result should contain only one insignificant digit. So what we will do? We have to understand here certain points while carrying out the multiplication and division. So in multiplication or in division, the final result should retain as many significant as are there in the original number with the least significant. Suppose we have length as this one, 2.613, and breadth as 1.2. When we multiply 2.613 into 1.2, we get 3.1356. But we are having here the least one. So how many these are having least significant number 1 and 2. So there are only 2. So we will take only 3.1. We'll take only 3.1 here. Only 2. We can't take all of these. Only least we have to take. When we divide, again the same thing. Suppose the mass of an object is 3.523, volume is 1.47. So the density of the object rho will be divide them. You get a number, you know. But we know that this is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 significant digit. This is having 3 significant digits. So we have to take 3. So 2.4, 2 we have to take, but because this is 9, so we have to convert or change this or increment it to 3. So 2.43 grams per centimeter cube. So the density is represented with 3 significant figure, because the measurement of volume, as you see here, has 3 significant figures. When two numbers are to be multiplied or divided, and out of them which is not a measurement is a definite number, the integer and fraction that occurs in general in the physics equation, they are definite number. In this equation, what we just said, let us take an equation, v square minus v0 square equal to 280. Now the coefficient of 2 is exactly 2. 2 is 2. 2 cannot be changed. So it has infinite number of significant figures, 2.0, 2.00. So in this case, we should not consider the significant figure of definite numbers. We'll deal with V0 and D. I'll give you an example. The diameter of a sphere is 4.24 cm. Now you have to calculate the surface area of a sphere to the correct number of significant figures. The diameter is given is 4.24. We know that the surface area of sphere is 4 pi r square. Right? R is d by 2. You know that radius is simply diameter by 2. So we can write 4 pi d by 2. Let us write it here and compute it. We get 56.47. But in this case, 4 and 2 are the definite numbers. We do not consider them. We do not consider them. And measure of D has 3 significant figures. What is this? 1, 2, 3. So the answer will also be rounded off to 3 significant digit or figure, 56.4, because this is 7. So we have to increment this 4 with, the 7 is greater than 5. So we have to increment this 4 with 1. So 56.5 will be the answer.